Hello and welcome to today's video. Every now and then I get emails from people asking me how much money they should spend to buy a first instrument to start learning the violin. And I also hear from customers that I have that they have bought instruments for not too much money on the internet, mostly on Amazon and these kind of sites. And I was wondering what kind of violin could you buy if you spent about $100. So I went on Amazon, had a look, and I decided to buy this instrument, which is supposed to be a set with a violin, a bow, and a case. And a couple of days ago it came in, and it is this package. And I have to say that when I saw the package, the first red flag came up, because as you see, it is a piece of plastic, and I can feel the case inside. You can see here, these are the stickers of the post. And I expected the violin to come in a box to protect it. So at this point, I'm not so afraid about the quality of the instrument than if the instrument is in one piece still, because I would never send a violin just practically just in the case. This plastic doesn't protect anything except maybe some humidity. Let's cut off the plastic and find out if it's in one piece and what I received. And indeed, as you see, there is no box, it is just the case. And that doesn't make me happy at all. As you understand, for $100 it is not even the best quality case. It is good enough to go to your lessons or so, but not to send an instrument. Anyway, let's find out. Okay, some instructions, a small cloth, instructions, not even, anyway. And the instrument, which still is in one piece, surprisingly. Okay, the first thing that I see is that the instrument is not mounted. That means that you have to do some mounting work on your own. Fortunately, the sound post is still not on its place, but it is standing. That means that you only have to put the bridge on its place and then you could play. There is also a bow. Let's say there is a piece of wood, a stick, that you can use as a bow. Let's have a look to the instrument from top to bottom, starting here at the scroll. The wood is of poor quality, but it is completely fine with me for that money. The pegs are not from ebony, but from hardwood. And that's pity, because hardwood pegs get worn out much faster than ebony pegs. And what I also don't like is that the pegs are not fitted completely to the end, like this one. This peg is good enough, but this one and at the other side the other two are also not fitted properly. The nut is also hardwood as the fingerboard. It is almost at the correct height. It is a bit too high, I think. I will have a better look later, but it is good enough. The fingerboard, which is also from hardwood as I just said, doesn't have the correct curve. It is almost impossible to show you well on video, but about here it has a bump. That means that I expect the notes that are here to give some buzz. We will find out later when I will play on the instrument. Going ahead to the back, it looks like flamed maple, but it isn't. This flaming is painted. You can see it because it doesn't move as I move the violin. That is not a big deal for me. It is a cheap instrument. They've done some effort to make it look better. It's good enough, but what I don't like is that the joint seems to be a little bit open, or in any case not very well glued at this part. Going to the front, let's have a look if the F-holes are placed correctly. They are spot on, and the neck is 4 millimeters longer than it's supposed to be. The body length is correct with 356 millimeters. The sound post is not placed correctly. It's almost impossible to show you, but I will take it out and put it on its place. Finally, we have here the bridge, which of course is poorly made, but it really looks like a violin bridge, so it's good enough for me. Let me put it on place and see if the height is correct. There are no markings for the strings, and that is a problem because you have to put the strings on your own. If there are no markings, then you don't know where to put it. What shall we do? I will make them on my own. I have the feeling that the strings are far too high. Let's measure a bit. They are both about a millimeter higher, and I have to say that you feel it. Anyway, let's go ahead. Tailpiece with fine tuners. These are the kind of cheap fine tuners. I know these kind of tailpieces, they work for a couple of months and then they don't work very well anymore. Anyway, and finally a chin rest, which is also made of hardwood. It is on the correct place. Overall, first impression is that the instrument is made good enough, but there are some problems which are functional. I think that the pegs, the bridge, and the tailpiece, and of course the quality of the strings, these are the cheapest strings you can find, are very important for the playability of the instrument, and that is where this instrument really comes short. I don't care so much about the quality of the wood and the scroll, but I want it to be tunable and playable, and that is not the case with this instrument. Anyway, let's listen to it, and then we will have a look what you have to do to make it playable. To play on the violin, I will need the bow, which is really a disaster. This is not an ebony frog, it is also some kind of hardwood. It has some tension, so it is possible to play with it, but that is everything. I would suggest to buy a new bow if you are planning to play on an instrument of this quality for some longer time. As the bow is brand new, it needs some rosin, and I'm going to use the rosin that was in the case. I was just tuning the instrument and one of the strings already broke. And it broke here close to the tailpiece. I can't find the other part anyway. That's not a very good start. It is the E string. Of course, I have more strings, but if you order a violin and before you play the first note, the string is already broken. I will put the dominant one that will be in favor of the instrument, of course. The sound quality is pretty poor, that was to be expected. What I don't like is that the bridge is too high, so I have to push the strings really deep, and at the upper nut the spreading is too narrow, so there is not enough space for my fingers, although the width of the fingerboard is good enough. Now let's have a look what you can do to make this instrument a bit better. I will start with the pegs. I want them to go a little bit deeper into the holes, and I'm going to put some paste on them so that they turn smoother. This is much better. I will change the spreading of the strings over the nut so that there is more space between them. Now we have the issue with a bump on the fingerboard. I'm going to use the plane to plane it away, and in that way I will be able to give the correct height to the bridge. Thank you. Now I could spend some time to paint the fingerboard again with black paint, but I don't want to wait until it is dry. That's why I'm going to use a marker. Next is the soundpost. Let's get it out. It's a bit broken. Let's throw this away. I changed a little bit both the sides. Now they have a correct angle. So I think that now it will get on the correct place and fit, let's say 80%. Which is not bad for this quality of instrument. Let's go ahead to the bridge. I'm going to lower one side. The side of the E string was too high. I'm going to make it a couple of millimeters lower. And I'm going to make the top a little bit rounder, so it is easier to play. Something like that has to go off. The height and curve of the bridge are okay now. I'm not going to work on the thickness. It is not too thick, or any other part, as I don't think that it is worth it. I'm just going to mount the instrument again, and I'm going to use a Vitner tailpiece with fine tuners. I like these tailpieces a lot. They work very well. And I'm going to mount a set of Tomastic Alpha U strings. Let's listen. The sound improved. It feels now a little bit less harsh and a bit softer, a bit warmer. It became more pleasant to play on. Of course, it is not the high-end quality instrument, but it is good enough for a beginner. It plays now much easier. There is more space between the strings. The strings are not too high, so they are easy to press in. But also, as these strings are a bit softer and a bit thicker, you don't feel them so much on the fingers. So what can be the end conclusion? These instruments are cheap instruments. They are offered as ready-to-play instruments, but in my opinion they are not. I have spent about an hour to fix all the small things, and I have to say that I also did it a bit faster. I would spend more time. I would probably make a new soundpost. I only corrected it a little bit, a better or new bridge. The fingerboard was terrible. I didn't color it properly. I could have done all these things also. That means that if you buy an instrument like that for $100, you will have to spend, I think, another $100 on strings and a tailpiece and someone to fix it properly. And the bow is really poor, maybe another $70 for a bit better bow. That means that you are going to spend close to $250, $300 at the end. In that case, maybe it's better to buy an instrument for $300 that is already finished well. I'm already working on a new video about an instrument that I might recommend. It might be a little bit more expensive, but also of a better quality. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel so you won't miss it. I understand also that not everyone has $300. You have to make your own conclusions. So that's it for today's video. Many thanks to the Patreons for supporting the channel. If you also appreciate my content and would like to support the channel, don't hesitate to visit my Patreon page. Thank you very much for watching, and I will see you next time again. Bye bye!